opening day festivities wrapping up, and we'll be back to get this season started right after this. Live from the north side of Chicago, Wrigley Field, opening day baseball on the show. It's the Milwaukee Brewers and the Chicago Cubs. Alongside my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Schampe. Thanks for joining us here. All right, partner, ready to go. Always a pleasure to get things started with you on opening day.
Well, happy new year, buddy. And anyone that's involved in baseball, even though it's not January 1st, this is the start of a new year. Every team has playoff hopes. I love this time of the year. I'm excited to get things going.
And now,
all right, we'll be back to get this one started after this.
Chicago Cubs.
All right, just about set to go, and pitching in this game, Michael Kopech. What do you look for here?
Well, last year kind of around the league average in terms of ERA, and you know what, that's why you have five different spots in the starting rotation. You've got to have people round things out, and not everyone's going to pitch like a number one or number two every outing or every season. But last year he gave his team an opportunity and a chance to win every time he took the mound on average. And when you look at that kind of performance, it has a place on every ball club.
And he deals. Liner, base hit. Bryce Terang with his first major league hit. And this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen. And when it does, it can kind of be overwhelming, Boog. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you could take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you've worked to get here.
And now it's Christian Yelich. That one's in there, 0-1. Now 1-1.
Oh, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity, try to get a rollover, something on the ground, stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Runner on the go. Pitch misses. And they got him.
Usually when you see a team try to steal a base in the early innings, it tells you they want to be aggressive on offense, try to force the defense to make plays and slow them down. That's exactly what they did right there. So we'll see if that caught stealing changes the offensive approach moving forward.
And a pitch. And a swing and a miss there.
Got away with that one. Left the curveball up a little bit. He's going to have to finish it if it's going to be an effective pitch.
Tapped out in front of the plate. Yelich out on the play. Let's take a look at the Brewers lineup. And the key to victory for them here, get their starter some run support early.
If they can get him that run support early, it's likely the other team folds because they know how dominant he can be once he gets settled in. So put pressure on that other team right away. Jump out to a lead early, and a few runs is going to feel like 30.
Willy Adames stands in. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. And misses inside.
Good fastball there. I think it was a purpose pitch. Just want to make that hitter's feet uncomfortable. And That location will definitely do it.
That one down the line. Oh, great stop. Nicely done for the out. One hit in the inning, but nothing more than that. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. Back here at the ballpark, and today's starting pitcher, Corbin Burns. Chris, a sub 3 ERA for him a year ago.
Well, when your numbers are coming in under 3 as a starting pitcher that's going out there every fourth or fifth day, taking the ball, competing against really good big league hitters, it's extremely impressive. And you wonder what he figured out last year that he can carry into this season that can help him to maintain that number or even drop it lower. We'll see, but we know he's got good stuff, and he should be really good in this one today.
Nico Hoerner in the box here lets that one go for a ball. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss as he was out front. Hoerner, a guy you think about with a strong baseball IQ, but just the overall smarts. He comes from an educational background. Both of his parents at one time taught at Stanford, and his mom currently is on the faculty at Cal. Pitch upstairs. Started to go after it. Now a look down to first. And yes, he offered at it. And here it comes. On the ground, right side. And that's a fair ball. Around first, digging for two. The throw in to the shortstop at second, but it pulls him off the base.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Dansby Swanson stands in, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. First pitch, and he just misses. Dansby Swanson's turned into one of the best defensive shortstops in baseball, Chris, and a lot of the help came from Ron Washington, but Dansby put in the work. Next pitch misses inside, and now 2-0. Dansby Swanson, after all of that hard work defensively, won himself the Gold Glove in 2022. Next offering is in for a strike. Hoerner at second with nobody out. Next pitch is inside, and now 3-1. Righty delivers. In the air, out towards right center. And it's into the gap. And they strike first as they take a 1-0 lead. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
Here's Rafael Devers. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. Burns, an all-star a season ago. He throws a cutter, a curve, a changeup, a slider, and he works in a sinker. Left-hand batter waits.
Boy, he's realizing out there on the mound that he's got to settle in pretty quickly or else he's going to get hit hard in this first inning.
Swings, threw it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
And now it's William Contreras. In there, and it's 0-1. And a pitch. That one fouled off. Man at second. Goes down swinging for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Oh, that pitch wasn't even close to being a strike, and that just goes to show you how defensive hitters can become when they're up against an 0-2 count. You're just hoping for a mistake somewhere near the zone that you can get the bat to, but right there, he was clearly anxious. He was swinging when the ball left the hand.
Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. One home run shy of 200 for his career. And that's in there for strike one. Man on second, two down. In the dirt, blocked. Nice job behind the plate there. Runner leads away at second. Swing and a miss. It's a ball and two strikes.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
And the righty deals. On the ground to third. Low throw, and he can't dig it out.
We all know that that first inning can be a critical one in terms of guys settling in and the tone being set for the game. So this isn't what you're looking for on defense. Two-out errors are a lot like two-out walks, but maybe even worse because your pitcher did his job to get what should have been the last out of that inning.
Cody Bellinger in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. The pitch. That one missed.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
The 1-1. Started to go after it. Now a look down to third, and he went around, according to Clyde Washington. Two on, two outs. And now 2-2.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
The pitch. 3-2 now. Three, two. kicks and fires. Stays alive. Corners are occupied with two down. Goes down looking. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. Second inning coming up here at Wrigley. It's the Cubs one and the Brewers nothing. Welcome back. Top of the second. And now it's Rowdy Tellez.
Rowdy Tellez.
Kopech back to work. Ball one, no strikes.
That's where you want. It's a good miss.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
Next offering upstairs. The wind of the pitch. Got him. One away. Here's Jesse Winker.
Jesse Winker.
And fouled off. The pitch. In the air, right side. Suzuki on the move. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. Two down.
Batting fifth. The third baseman, number
two. Two outs, bases empty. Next for the Brewers, Luis Urias.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field. But he can jump you if you make a mistake.
In there for strike one.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Yeah, the right-hander deals. And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Brewers go down quietly. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Here at Wrigley Field, we head to the bottom of the second. So up now for Chicago, Seiya Suzuki.
Suzuki.
And a pitch. There's a strike.
If he doesn't get a knock right here, that pitch he just took is going to eat at him for a while. You might not see another pitch like that from a top level guy like this.
And the 0-1. And there's a foul ball. The 0-2.
One ball, two strikes.
Fouls it back with two strikes. The pitch. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Righty to the plate. Now a screamer into the outfield. And there's one away.
Batting it. The first base.
Here's Hosmer.
Hosmer.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. One down, base is empty.
I got a ball, one strike.
Ed Drummond, our umpire behind the plate in this one.
Yeah, Boogie's a really fair umpire, both the pitchers and the hitters. So standard strike zone, he's consistent with it. And the great thing is you don't see players questioning the calls too much. So that's a good thing in this day and age.
Ball to strike. And downstairs. Singy, what kind of strike zone is most frustrating for hitters?
I'd say off the plate, away, and down. And why? Those are the toughest locations to hit the baseball.
Here's a 2-1. And there's the strike. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Next pitch is inside, and now 3-2. Struck him out looking.
That's just a nasty pitch right there, and I'm not surprised at all that he got the strikeout looking at the plate. Looks like it's a fastball off the corner the entire way until just that very last second when that cutting action takes over and brings it back to clip the outside corner. You just got to tip your cap sometimes, but overall, that's just a nasty pitch.
Trey Mancini now. That one's in there, 0-1. And a pitch. And a foul ball. Two outs. Ball one there.
Two strikes.
And he deals. Spoils a two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Next offering way off the plate. And a pitch. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's the inning. And the Cubs are down in order, but they lead it 1-0. The north side of Chicago, John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. And here is Tyrone Taylor. Kopech, a 6'3 righty, 210 pounds, a former first round pick back in 2014. Curveball over for a called strike. Taylor getting the start in right, 29 years old, and he was a second round pick back in 2012. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he's gotten ahead with two pitches down in the zone. He has plenty of options right here. He can go up, he can go away, he can add velocity, he can subtract.
And he'll 2. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again.
Ooh, missed a mistake right there.
Line of the pitch. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with the high fastball and then bury that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
Now, here is Garrett Mitchell in there, and it's 0-1. That one pulled foul. Here's the 0-2. And ball one.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
The 1-2. Got it by him for the K. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now 3 in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Vic Caratini at the plate. Caratini goes 6'1", 215 pounds, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. In there for strike one. Right-hander kicks deals. Now 1-1.
1-1.
There's a strike.
The guy's going this good. He's retired 7 in a row. You got to step out of the box, fake bunt, do something to break it up.
struck him out looking. Fastball at the letters froze him for strike three.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
As we go to the last of the third, here's Nico Horner,
the second baseman.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
The pitch. There's the strike. Burns, 28 years old. He's a former National League Cy Young Award winner. Here comes a pitch to third. Throw over to Tellez, and a quick out number one.
The batter number seven, shortstop Dansby.
At the plate, Dansby Swanson doubled in his first AB.
Swanson, former first round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks, Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
Swanson batting second in today's lineup, and he's a former National League Gold Glover. And a rope into center field, base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one out single.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Man aboard, and here is Devers. Devers, the baby-faced assassin. First offering misses the mark. Righty delivers, and it's fouled away. Here's a 1-1. And that's in for a strike. One, two now. Now he breaks his bat. Takes it in for the out.
Now batting, catcher, William Contreras.
At first, and here's the catcher, William Contreras. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. And that's in there for strike one. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Everything came now together perfectly for him right there. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Next to hit, Kyle Schwarber. Going one.
All ones account.
Swanson over at second. Contreras on at first with two down. And here it comes. That misses. And that's ball one.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well. So much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
At the belt and fires. That misses the zone. Two and two. Left-hand batter waits, and down on strikes, and that is that. A couple of hits in the inning, but they can't get him home. On to inning number four. It's the Cubs one, and the Brewers nothing. All set for the start of the inning. This is Bryce Turang.
Second baseman, Bryce Turang.
Kopech back to work. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, he's just glad that he got hit with an off-speed pitch there instead of a fastball. Man, that would have hurt a lot more if it had velocity.
Yelich in the box now. Take strike one. Next offering is in for a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
In the air, left field. And there's one down.
Now that shortstop, Willie Adames.
Willie Adames up now for the Brewers. 0 for 1 so far.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
And first offering is fouled off. The pitch. Breaking ball through there for a strike.
Dangerous spot for that slider right there. Didn't seem to quite finish out front and get that sharp break. Tell you what, he doesn't want to throw that pitch again.
Oh, and two now. And that's outside. And the righty deals. And it's even up. Next offering misses down and away. The pitch. Battling here as he fouls it away. Three, two. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
I'm not sure that was the exact location the pitcher wanted, but it worked. He got the swing and miss, and I'm sure a bit of sigh of relief after seeing that one go through the zone.
Here's Rowdy Tellez. 0 for 1, he struck out swinging last time. And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. That one's in there. 0-2 now. Kicks and deals. Swing and a miss, and that is that. Brewers strand one. They're down 1-0. Back here at the friendly confines, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the center fielder, Cody Bellinger.
Cody Bellinger, no stranger to the big stage. He played in the 2007 Little League World Series. He's the 14th player ever to play in both the Little League World Series and the Major League World Series.
First offering, and it just misses. And the pitch just missed. Next pitch is outside.
A rare three ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Next pitch in for a strike, 3-1.
Generally, second, third time through the lineup, you want to be able to lean on those secondary pitches and command them. Looks like he's doing a nice job of it.
The 3-1. There's the strike.
Thank you.
That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Now it's the right fielder, Seiya Suzuki. He's 0 for 1. That one's in there, 0-1.
There it was, a high velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Kicks and fires. Bounding ball here, rolls foul. Bellinger on at first, nobody out. And that one lifted in the air center field. And it falls. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out.
Hitting is really easy for some guys. One thing that I could see already, his bat stays in the zone on plane for an extended period of time. And guys like that, they have a high contact rate and they have more barrels because of that bat being on plane. And even when you don't get it great, it's still hit hard enough to dunk something in like that in front of the center fielder.
Swing and a ball popped up. Reaching for it, makes the catch.
Up next for the Cubs, the designated hitter, Trey Mancini.
Now it'll be the Cubs' DH, Trey Mancini. He struck out swinging at his first at-bat. In there for strike one. Runners at first and second with one gone. And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it. Got him swinging.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically he likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Nico Horner, the next Cub to hit. Good contact guy, good defender. Base hit center field. Bellinger on his way home. Here comes the throw. Throw is wide. He's off the bag. Run scores, and this inning continues.
Now here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
Dansby Swanson is going to get a chance to hit. They say it went. Two outs, two in scoring position. Ball. Next pitch misses, and the count even one and one. Movement in Milwaukee's bullpen. Adrian Hauser preparing to come on if needed. Pitch. There's a strike. In the air, right field. Taylor ranging after it. Squeezes it. And that's the inning. One run in the inning, but they leave two. But the RBI single pushes across a run. And it's 2-0. Major League Baseball is on the show. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's the Brewers DH, Jesse Winker. Jesse Winker, a former first-round pick, a guy who was drafted originally by the Reds. He was an all-star starter in 2021 in that National League outfield with Brian Reynolds and his then Reds teammate Nick Castellanos. Horner collects it, tosses to first, and Winker is set down.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Here's Luis Urias. His first at bat was a strikeout. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Ball one, no strike.
There, that misses off the outside edge.
Pretty easy to give up on that pitch right there. Started on the edge of the plate with the spin. You know it's going to finish well off the plate.
And here it comes. There's a strike. And a 2-1 on the way. To the left side, but it is well foul.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
And a pop-up right side, foul territory. He makes the catch, and there's two down.
The right fielder, number 15, Tyrone
Taylor. Tyrone Taylor up now for the Brewers. The outfield playing him to pull with the center fielder positioned in that left center field gap. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
0-1.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Next offering misses, and a count 1-2.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
One and two now. And there's a ball.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to lay off.
This one in the air, center field. Bellinger coming on. And that is that. Gone in order are the Brewers. And they're down 2-0. And welcome back. Now it's going to be Rafael Devers.
The third baseman, Rafael Devers.
The pitch. Here's a strike.
Pretty impressive. We haven't seen that pitch from him much, but he's got a really good feel when he throws it.
And he deals. That misses the zone, and it's 1-1. And a pitch. And a count 1-2. Righty to the plate. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Next one misses, and it's 2-2.
This guy's a fun guy to watch taking it bat. He just battles up there. He doesn't take a pitch off at all. Makes it so difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put him away.
Next offering is downstairs. and a pitch. Ground ball right side. In plenty of time to first, and Devers is set down.
Now batting, catcher, William Contreras.
Here's the power-hitting catcher, William Contreras, one for two.
Well, I got a chance to meet William during spring training as he was coming up trying to get to the big leagues, and this kid's got some ridiculous pop. Watched him on the backfields taking batting practice. All of his coaches would just kind of roll their eyes and say, this kid's going to be great, without actually saying the words. Then later that season, I got a chance to chat with Wilson, big brother, and ask him about little brother, and he smiled as well, said, yeah, he's good, and gave me that look that I think he might be better than me eventually.
There's a strike.
1-1.
The pitch. That's way high. Through. Righty delivers. That's off the mark. And that's ball three. Swing and a ball hammered left field. And that is a foul ball. It goes down looking. Two outs, bases empty. And up next for Chicago, Kyle Schwarber. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. Pitch misses inside. Ball one. And he pumps it a strike. Right-hander kicks, deals. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Here comes a pitch. And that's outside. Two down, nobody on. And now it's 3-2. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Pitch count's getting up there now, and not saying that's the reason for this walk, but this is the point in the game when every sign of wavering starts to get everyone's attention.
Bellinger in the box now. No balls and a strike. Yoan. That one missed. at the belt and fires.
Ball that's outside.
Fouls one off, 2-2. The pitch. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. Cubs leave one, but they're on top 2-0. Back here at Wrigley Field, here's a speed threat. Garrett Mitchell.
Number five, Garrett Mitchell.
Kopech back to work. Just off the outside edge.
Well, these Brewers, from what we've seen, I think it's fair to wonder if they've been too patient at the plate. Sometimes it's a good thing, but today they're continuing to fall behind in the count, and that's adding a ton of pressure to their offense.
The next offering misses, and that's ball two. And the pitch swings and misses, and it's 2-1.
Instead of letting the hitter get his arms extended, tied him up a little bit, slightly up, slightly in.
The wind of the pitch, and that's in for a strike.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Line drive, base hit.
Now batting, catcher.
Dominant performance for him today, Boo. Just two hits allowed so far, no runs across either, and he's had an answer for just about every hitter he's faced, so I don't think this hit is going to knock him off his stride too much.
And now the switch hitting catcher, Victor Caratini.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
You won. And a base hit on a line. Makes the turn at second, heads for third. Bellinger returns it to the infield, and the runner holds at third.
Now batting, the second baseman, Bryce.
So digging Terang. In, Bryce Terang. In there for strike one. The pitch. Strike two. And the pitch. And takes low for ball one.
One ball, two strikes.
Mitchell, the runner at third. Caratini on at first with nobody out. Next offering way upstairs. And the right-hander deals. Gets a piece and stays alive. Caught him looking for the K.
So far, just one of those days for this lineup. You get a couple of runners on, and you're looking at having a big inning, and that strikeout right there just pours water on the fire. Look for the next hitter to step up and try to do something, pick up his teammate and his club.
Here's Yelich at the dish.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Runners are at the corners, one away. Hammered on the line, base hit. Runner from third comes across, and it's a one-run game.
Big time at bat right there. Comes through and they're back within a run. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Up now for Milwaukee, Willie Adames. Outfield playing very deep, not wanting anything over their heads.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about something being hit to the right side into the outfield is that the base runner at second has a very good read and can determine whether or not he can score on that base hit.
One out. Runners at first and second. And now 2-0. And a pitch. Foul ball. Kicks and fires. Double steal. That one fouled off. 2-2. So the tying run at second. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
Well, that slider down and away, it's just kind of a slow death. With two strikes, you're looking to protect. And halfway to the plate, you know you've committed. And you know you're going to have no chance of touching it. Tell you what, sometimes you just have to tip your cap.
So first and second with two outs. And now Rowdy Tellez. In there, and it's 0-1. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Next pitch misses. 1-2 to Cal. Missed inside with the curve. Left-hand hitter waits. Stays alive. And he struck him out. Good job at damage control right there.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
New arm out of the bullpen, Joel Piamps.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Well, one run game. So up now for Chicago, Seiya Suzuki. Suzuki, 28 years old. He joined the team as a free agent. The pitch. Piamps, 28 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Next offering is in for a strike.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Papi, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
That one the other way. Nice grab.
Great hops right there, Boog. He timed it just right to bring that liner down, and he saved it up.
Now it's Eric Hosmer. Hosmer, a member of the 1,000 Hit Club. And he's a former All-Star Game MVP. Towards first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Trey Mancini.
Trey Mancini, the next Cub to hit. Who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. Fouled off. He was late. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Cubs are down quietly. They lead it 2-1. We go to the top of the seventh, and now Jesse Winker.
Jesse Winker.
The right-hander back to work. Yeah, that skips into dirt. Well, he's back out there to begin the seventh. That surprised you at all, Chris?
Yeah, a little bit. It was a little rough sixth inning there, but his skipper's got a lot of confidence in him. But trust me, they will keep a close eye on how he does in this one.
The tying run at the plate.
Hey! I got a ball, one strike.
Left-hand batter waits. And that one wrapped foul. Looking to get the tying run on base. Good job to fight that one off. Next offering is fouled back. Next one misses. The count now 2-2. And now it's filled up.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
And the righty deals. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
No outs. Runner at first. Next for Milwaukee, Luis Urias. And first offering is fouled off. On the ground to Devers. To second, there's one. Plenty of time at first. That's a double play.
Now back the right field, Tyrone Taylor.
Tyrone Taylor up now for the Brewers. The outfield playing him to pull with the center fielder positioned in that left center field gap. First pitch, just misses. And another ball. This one high in the air to left center. Bellinger makes the catch, and that'll do it.
Rejoin us for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Bottom of the seventh. Now it's the second baseman, Nico Horner. Chris, his skill set straight out of the mid-80s. Good contact, not much power. And he could run. He always uses the wheels to his advantage.
His biggest challenge in this day and age is to not get caught up in trying to hit home runs because so many people are. I think baseball's starting to understand that those guys are valuable like they once were. They need him in this game today.
Out towards left center. Pulls it in on the run. One away.
Now batting, shortstop,
Dansby. And next for the Cubs, Dansby Swanson. In there for strike one.
Some guys are just more confident if they can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
The 0-1. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count, he's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Next offering down in the dirt. Good eye right there.
Two balls, two strikes.
Left field. Yelich should have it. He's got it, and there's two away.
As good as he's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand, you cannot hang a breaking ball right there. Lucky it stayed in the ballpark.
And it's Rafael Devers in the box. The outfield shifted pretty heavily towards right field. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. And Devers hits that one. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That is the inning. Three up, three down for the Cubs. But they still lead it 2-1.
Now, this guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth, Adbert Alzolot.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here. You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
And he deals. That one's in there. Strike one. Movement in the Cubs bullpen. Michael Fulmer throwing and getting ready for David Ross. Hughes, a left-hander, also throwing. Next offering is down low.
One ball, one strike.
And here it comes. Nope. Falling behind 2-1.
2-1.
And a pitch. Next offering misses down and away.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now.
Big time GM right there. I hate it as a hitter, but standing in center field, you can't help but chuckle a little bit.
Kicks and deals. lifted in the air right center field. Bellinger sizing it up, brings it in, one up, one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
To the right side. Corner handles the chance. Out on the underhand toss.
Good slider inside right now there. Batter fighting to get there. Just rolled over it. Got the ground ball.
So up next, Bryce Terang. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Rolled over to third, and he picks it up in foul territory. Righty to the plate. Foul ball there. Two now.
At the ball.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off speed's probably coming.
On the ground to third, and that's just foul.
No signs of wavering on the mound here in the eighth. He's looking rock solid so far.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty delivers in the air, center field. Bellinger drifts towards it. He's got it, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee, and our score remains 2-1. Aaron Ashby on the pitch out of the pen here. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Aaron Ashby.
And now, William Contreras,
for the Cubs,
1-for-3.
The catcher.
He is William. A talented player. His Judge big brother, Wilson, Herrera. Has voice that his little brother may end up being better than he is.
The pitch. Slider now misses outside. There's a strike. And now the lefty. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. One, two now. This to third. Urias over to pick it up. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
Now batting, the left fielder, Kyle Schwarber.
And up next for Chicago, Kyle Schwarber.
His next home run will be the 200th in his career. It would be pretty cool to see it right here.
That hits the dirt, 1-0. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Good eye right there. Pitch misses, and it's 3-0. Kicks and fires. And that's ball four.
Perfect.
How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
Bellinger stands in now and watches strike one. The pitch.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole, he's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake. One guy that was really great once the count got to two strikes, Miguel Cabrera.
Here comes a pitch. Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. One run game, one out, one on. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-2. At the belt and fires. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Left-hand hitter waits and delivers outside. Pitch spoils that one, and it remains 2-2.
Still.
Runner takes off, fouls that off to the left, and we'll do it again. Schwarber leads off first with one away. Runner goes again. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Next offering is foul back. Thank you. Runner on the move again. Swing and a miss. Throw to second. Great jump. And that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close. Seiya Suzuki, the next Cub to hit. First offering misses badly for ball one. Runner at second, two down. Next pitch is outside. Down the inside corner for a strike. Swing and a miss. And the count is even, 2-2.
This guy's sink has so much drop in it, it's almost like a split finger fastball. Instead of just weak contact and balls on the ground, he gets swings and misses.
2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Runner leads away at second. Up the middle, Adames picks it up. Throw is low, and he can't pick it.
Maybe just a little lack of concentration on that throw. Two out, you think you've got the play made. Guys are starting to move off the field towards the dugout, and then everyone's got to come back. Sometimes you take that throw for granted, and that's all it takes to keep the inning going.
So two down, Eric Hosmer, the next Cub to hit.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Now the 0-1. And strike two.
No ball, two strikes.
Two on, two outs. Bounce to the left side. To first. And that is the inning. Cubs strand a couple as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Brandon Hughes.
And they felt it was time to bring on a left-handed reliever from the pen with the lefty hitter coming up. I think it's a good move. I know I never liked when opposing team did that to me.
Now it's Christian Yelich. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. Pitch. That's inside.
You want to get beat by a fastball in, and he spits on that one.
And the pitch. Missing inside. Now 2-0. looking to get the tying run on base. Just missed.
Almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
In for a strike. Now 3-1. Tried to check his swing. Appeal to third. No swing. He held up just enough. That's ball four.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
And things could change quickly here with one swing. If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
First offering, and it just misses.
Good to lay off that pitch down.
And here it comes. Popped up. Swanson moving under this one. Hauls it in, one away.
The batter, the first baseman,
Rowdy Tellez, up now for the Brewers.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate and try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
First offering misses the mark. And a pitch. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Bellinger drifts towards it, and it's caught for the out.
Now batter, designated hitter,
Jesse Winker, up now for the Brewers.
Right now they're looking for something hit hard into the gaps, give them an opportunity with two outs to score that run from first.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. The next pitch misses. Two balls, no strikes. Clips a corner. The 2-1. And there's a ball.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
And he deals. Out to short. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Cubs hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, his first save of the season is in the books, and that was a nice job of him coming in the game and closing it out. He's off and running now.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 2 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 9 runners on base. For the Brewers, 1 run, 4 hits, 2 errors. They left 4 runners on base. Time of the ball.